Tell me about it. I guess everybody's asking about the tour bus. What happened?
Well, I left on Wednesday night to head here just for a day early to just kind of chill before a really busy weekend.
Okay.
And yesterday morning, a tire blew and caught on fire, and we had to evacuate. And it was all over the news. We had choppers circling around our heads. But everybody was safe.
Okay.
Everybody was safe.
Mm-hmm. How long did it delay you?
Well, it delayed us, but it really delayed everybody behind us on the interstate way more. But, you know, it was one of those things to where the fire just really grew very, very rapidly. And, first responders came and showed up and got it out. But then because it's a huge tour bus, it took a lot to get it towed out and out of the way. So, hopefully no one's cussing me too much today.
You didn't have, like, a group of guys stop, like, in Salina. And say, hey, I fixed the bus.
Oh, we did have some people. Growing up in the South, we call them rubberneckers, who have a tendency to just kind of watch and slow down and make sure they're catching all the details.
Now, if you guys are traveling in a car, just say, for example, and you did have car trouble among yourselves, you're flat or whatever, who would be the one to fix the car?
Not one of us.
I bet Charles's instincts would kick in.
I could go a tire, but like as far as the engine goes, I would be pretty much just trying to,
call AAA.
No, I've had to change a tire before. Probably last time I had to do it, though, was in high school. But, you open up the hood. This boy right here, it's just
What about around the house? You handy around the house?
I can do some things around the house now. That I can.
Light bulbs here, there.
I can do that.
Which one would you call if you needed something, a toilet fixed at your house? Which one of these
a
two guys?
A toilet, I would call Charles.
Yeah.
She's basically saying I'm a master in the toilet because I'm in the bathroom all the time.
Read into that as you will.
I'm an expert on.
Knows his way around a toilet.
it's where I do my business meetings.
Any kind of computer, like IT, is all Dave Haywood.
Well, I don't take much pride in that, I guess.
Okay, and what do they call you for?
I don't know.
She can cook a home-cooked meal now.
Really?
That's very sexist. Like,
no,
very. Out of all the things to say,
way.
But
I
it's
take
like
pride in that.
Yeah. And I don't have a kid yet, but I would call her to help babysit. She's a great mother.
Good babysitter. I think they're just pretty much saying you're the chick.
Yeah, she's the one.
Well, yeah.
These are all very. My wife would get mad because my wife is like a I am woman. Hear me roar. So if I was just to say talk about cooking and caring for kids, she'd get upset.
If you want to go shoot hoops, we go with Hillary.
Yeah, if you want to go shoot hoops.
Really?
Yeah.
The most athletic of the three of you?
She can swing a tennis racket.
There's a reason that I'm 6'6 and I sing for a living. I should be playing basketball with this height. It's a waste of height.
I feel you. I mean, do people ask you that? I mean,
all the time.
Being a white guy, I don't know if they ask you that. Yeah. They ask me that.
Hey, true.
You play basketball?
They kind of already assume I'm no good at it.
All right, guys. I'll give you the wrap over here. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Have fun.
Great to talk to you.